number 7. We have h of x. Equals natural log of 5x squared. Okay, so we want to do the derivative of this. Okay, the derivative is going to be, well, let's see. Oh, we've got a natural log. So the rule for natural logarithms and I'm going to use the version that includes the entire chain rule in it, okay? It's going to be 1 over u times du dx.
1 over u, use the variable, right?
No. U is actually, this accounts for the fact that you could have a function in here. Okay? U is general, u, v, w usually designate functions. X, Y usually designate variables, X, Y, or Z. So what do we have here? So according to this, it's going to be 1 over the thing in the parentheses, so 1 over 5X squared times the derivative of 5X squared.
10X.
Yeah, 10X, that's just a power rule. So 1 over 5X squared times 10 times x. Okay, that's easy enough. Let's simplify that. So h prime of x, our derivative, is going to be, let's see, 10 over 5 gives us 2, and x over x squared gives us an x in the denominator. Okay, all I did was 10 over 5x squared, right? And I simplified it. So that one was pretty easy.
And then you divided the x's, and that makes it a
10 divided by 5 is 2. And over x over x squared is an x in the denominator. So that one was pretty easy. Looks scary because there's a logarithm in it, but it's a piece of cake. Okay.
How do you know that you do the h of prime, like the derivative? Just because you have
the... Because the question said, find the derivative.
Oh.
All of these questions start out with the sentence, find the derivative.
What number is this?
That was number 7. The next one is number 8. And again, they're all find the derivative problems. So let's see what we got here from number 8. This one is a little bit, this is one of those tricky ones